Hey guys, what's up? This is Gormizer, and I'm here with a really cool mod for you today. This is a mod I have reviewed before, but this mod has been updated. It is probably one of my favorite mods. It is the SecurityCraft mod, and it is really great if you have a server and you just don't want your friends getting into your shit, or you like trolling, which is what these items over here are for. But I'll get into those in a little bit. The mod creator for this is—he's a really cool guy. He really is earnestly working on this, and he'll take all the feedback you want. So it's really nice. And as you could see in the little intro there, gave a little demo of some of the things inside this mod. It's really cool. And so right here, I'm gonna go through all of the items. I'll show some of them off. You've seen some of them, but I'll go through and name them again. But I'm just gonna go through and give you the items, the names, and the recipes for all of the items before I get into what's all. How you use it. So, starting over here, we have the laser block. You can see those right down there. And it's exactly what it sounds like. When you place these together, you get a laser between the two. It gives a redstone signal, which allows you to set up traps based on people walking through and things like that. And so, the recipe for this laser block is a bunch of, it's a smooth stone and an upside down U, a piece of glass, and a block of redstone. Now, a block of redstone's relatively new. I think it was 1.6 added that in, but you need 9 redstone to make that, and you obviously smell cobblestone. Alright, so let's over here. The keypad, this is something I hit it on the door, and you need this for another item in the game, or in the mod as well. So, this is just buttons. It's 9 buttons in a crafting table, like that. It's real simple to make, and pretty easy. An iron trap door. Take a trap door, surround it in iron. It's exactly what it sounds like. It's like an iron door. You need to have a redstone signal, so a switch, a button, a lever, a button, or even a laser block, or the scanners, the various scanners in this game. The various timers in this, or the various scanners in this game will open that as well if you set it up right. The door remover is shears with 2 iron. What this does is it... Hi, Mr. Enderman. Bye, Mr. Enderman. What it allows you to do is remove a door. You just knock down the door, kind of like a, what is that, battering ram. The mine, self-explanatory, it's a mine, it blows shit up. You got 3 iron ingots and gunpowder, and the next few items use the mine. So obviously you have a dirt mine, it's a piece of dirt in a mine, and the recipe's the same for the stone mine, the cobble mine, the diamond ore mine, the sand mine. The diamond ore mine is odd because you can't actually get diamond ore playing just vanilla Minecraft. You have to spawn it in. Or, I think there might be a pick that drops the ore instead of the thing that it normally comes out of, or normally comes with it, but that one's going to be hard to make. The sand mine, obviously sand in a mine. The furnace mine is a furnace in a mine. And the bouncing Betty is a weighted pressure plate. This is the first time I've ever seen this used in a mod. It's the weighted pressure plate with 2 iron ingots and, and some gunpowder. I think that's actually kind of cool because it uses stuff that was added in recently. More recently, at least. And you've seen the mines. That was the diamond ore mine was what I used in the beginning over there, where I blew a hole underground. And so you know the mines, like, it's when you dig them, maybe when you stand on them here. Let's find out. Is this one? Where'd it go? Anyway, going on with that, we have the code breaker. Now, there is a bug with the code breaker in multiplayer right now. He's working on a patch for this. But in single player, it works fine. And what it is you... You put it up, like, the keypad right over there, or right there, if you will, and it breaks the code for you. And obviously something like this is a very powerful item in a multiplayer server where you want people to be locked away from your stuff. Stuff? Wow. How did I say that wrong? Anyway, the code breaker is obviously really strong, so that means it's really hard to make. So you've got 2 diamond, which are hard to find. Well, not as hard to find anymore. 2 gold ingots, not that hard. Redstone, not that hard. And emerald, those are kind of rare, but you can still find them. A redstone torch isn't hard. Now, a nether star, though, is a challenge to find, mainly because it's only dropped by the wither. And the wither is the boss that you get in the nether if you kill 3 wither skeletons. So now down to the second row, we have several items over here to go through. And so the first I'm going to start with the inventory scanner. I don't exactly know what the inventory scanner does. I couldn't get it to work. But as you can see, there is no recipe for it yet. And I'm assuming it will scan your inventory and maybe duplicate it. I'm not entirely sure. But It has to be connected to another inventory scanner block, so I'm not entirely sure how this works, but there's also no recipe for it yet. The key card reader, which I used that in the beginning. I had two of them linked up to my iron door, and you make this with a bunch of smooth stone and a hopper. Yeah, that's exactly what it looks like. So you can, when you click it, you have to set the level, and you can change it 1, 2, 3. And that determines what kind of card you need. I'll go over the cards in a little bit, but you set it to, like, level 1, and then when you hit it, that sends a redstone signal through it and will unlock doors for you. This is the retinal scanner. The retinal scanner also does not have a recipe yet, but you saw this in the beginning. They do work, and it registers if it's your... if you placed it. If you didn't place it, you don't get it. And I think that's a really cool thing. Reinforced iron bars are just like iron bars, but stronger, as you could imagine. It's iron bars surrounded by four iron ingots like that in a star kind of shape. But yeah, so it's stronger than iron bars. I have a lot of them. That's what that's built of over there. A track mine is a rail plus a mine. I assume I couldn't actually find the recipe, so I just assumed that that would be the recipe for it. The password-protected chest. Now, this is going to be a doozy, because this has caused a crash every now and then, but it hasn't. And so, what this is obviously, it's a chest with a keypad in it, so you have to, you know, put in a password. We made it 1, 2, 3, 4, and there's the recipe for it. So you have a U of iron ingots, a chest in the middle, and a keypad on the top to act as the key for this. In this, you also have fake lava, which instead of doing... So normal lava kills you. Fake lava just kind of doesn't, if that makes any sense. Portable radar. You make that with upside-down U and iron ingots, redstone, and redstone torch. This thing's actually kind of cool. I don't have one, but oh well. I'd show it. It kind of... You place it down, and it tells you when things are nearby. So it's a pretty cool little nifty thing to have. Level 1, here are the key cards. I have a 1 in 3 key card on me, and they go with the code reader right over there, the card reader. And so you can set the level of the card reader to be 1, 2, or 3, and they're harder to make as they go along. The first one is gold ingots and silver ingots, like so. The second one is silver ingots and bricks, which is actually a little easier to make than the first one. And this one is iron ingots and nether bricks. So that one's, you have to go to the nether to get that. I'm not even sure if you can get nether bricks by themselves. I don't know if you can do that. This is another item that does not have a crafting recipe right now, but is a mine remote access tool. What I assume it would do is if you have a mine set, you can remotely access it and detonate it probably. And this one, is there a recipe? There's no recipe for this, and there's no texture, but it works. I actually had one in the ground over there. And it's actually really cool how this thing works. It's a really good trap, so I'll show that off. And the bucket of fake water. This is the opposite of a bucket of fake lava. A bucket of fake lava doesn't hurt you like lava does, but a bucket of fake water hurts you like lava does. And I'll show that in a second. I'll probably die from that. Alright, so real quick, I switched to survival. I'm going to show off the fake lava and the fake water. So normally water doesn't hurt and lava hurts, but in this case, lava doesn't hurt. It still makes the burning noise and catches you on fire, but as you can see, I'm not losing any hearts, but I am on fire. But then you can just, you know, hop on out, and voila. Whereas, now I'm about to die really quickly, because this is crazy. See? Not even, there's not even a chance of getting out of that. So I'm right over here. I'm also going to show, so these are the laser blocks, to show off more of the mod. These are the laser blocks. And they're very, very helpful. Like, I have them linked up to lamps to show them off, but you can show them off to other things. You can link these to other things, so it's kind of useful for setting up traps. I didn't actually want to set up a trap because I don't want to blow anything up. And if you notice this texture is missing, that's because it's the cage trap from before. I just broke that by accident. Oh well. So if I step into the cage trap, as you see, it traps me. I think that might have been iron below me. And it tells, you know, it tells you people were caught in a trap, and obviously I can fly, so I can just get the hell out. But I think that's really cool. And it looks like it's made of the reinforced iron bars that are in the mod as well. So here's a keypad and a reinforced iron door. I guess we didn't show that up there. I don't think there's a recipe for it. All right, so what I'm going to do here is I'm going to show off the door remover. I have a reinforced iron door here, and you see you have to right-click the door, and it removes it right gone. Look at that. But it tells people that you destroyed the door, so you have to be careful when you use that, good and evil. So this is a keycard reader, obviously. I showed this a little bit in the beginning. You take a keycard. This one's set to level 3. You use it. It gives off a redstone signal, as you can see there, and you can go through. And that's the iron trap door. We also have a level 1 keycard below it where you can use it, and it will open it up. I had to set up some redstone for that. And here's a really cool thing of tech right here, is that the retinal scanners depend. Like, I placed this one down. When I look in that, it says, "Hello, Gormizer," and opens the door. Matt, my friend who's hosting the server, posts this one down, and unknown player, denying access. It doesn't let you through. And back here was where the diamond mines were, so as you can imagine, those are simply gone. And so this works from all sides, which is nice, because you can go look in it wherever you want. This works through redstone, which is really nice. And everything here distributes a very nice, very clean, easy redstone path, if it needs to. And it's just a really nice mod for placing things like, I guess, if you want a chest that your friends can't get into, or you want a house that zombies won't just break into automatically, or you want to set traps for your friends inside their houses, using maybe a cobblestone block. But, you know, I've talked a lot about this mod, and it's a really cool mod, but some people don't know how to install this mod, so I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how to install this mod. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how to install this mod. It is very easy to install. You just need two things. You need Forge 1.7.2 and SecurityCraft version 1.5 from 1.7.2. I will put a link to the mod in my description, so it will be very simple. You just click the link, go to his page, click download, and you got it. So, to make this clear, before you can install any of this, you have to make sure that you have run Minecraft 1.7.2 before trying to install Forge or the mod. Mainly because if you haven't, it won't have the directory to build off of in order to run it. So, first I'm going to go ahead and have you hit down here, go into here, and type in %appdata%. That'll bring up a folder called the roaming folder. Go ahead and open that and you'll see this .minecraft. Keep this window open, but first double-click on Forge. This will bring up a window. Just go ahead and say yes. And it'll bring up this nice, clean mod system installer. It'll say install client, install server, and extract. So what you want to do for this is install client and hit OK. It will download the libraries, unpack them, and so forth, and that will actually do it for you. Mods used to be so hard to install, and they were very complicated, but now you just hit a couple buttons and it's successfully installed. So in this Forge, you go ahead and hit play. It will load up the Forge version of Minecraft 1.7.2. Just like that. And you see you have three mods installed already. That's the Minecraft Coder Pack, Forge Mod Loader, and Minecraft Forge. Those are the things that Forge installs to run the mod. So let's go ahead and quit this. Keep Minecraft at the ready to open if you want. But now you'll have a mods folder. And in the mods folder, you can just drop SecurityCraft, reopen Minecraft, and then once you have Minecraft, you can select Forge. You want to do it in the Forge class, or profile. You press play, and here we go. Four mods loaded. Coder Pack, Mod Loader, Minecraft Forge, and SecurityCraft 1.5. And you can disable the mod if you don't want to play it. I don't recommend you do that because it is a great mod. The mod creator is really good at doing what he has done. It is really impressive. It is an awesome mod. So I recommend downloading it. Use it on your servers. Use it in your single player. Just have fun with it. It's a really cool mod with all the little security stuff it adds. And, you know, happy gaming, guys!